Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linen Associates with your financial market update, and this is for Wednesday, the 18th of October, 2017, 4:15 p.m., Cubs Day, do or die. Tonight, we'll tell the story if they can move on and try to get back some of their glory, but they're not looking that good, I have to say. When we look at the stock market, big updates again, the NASDAQ giving up something, and I'm not surprised. Remember what I told you when we began the rotation with first the Russell coming down, which it did. It went back to its 18-day average. Now we're getting a little bit of a stall, nothing like we saw in the Russell when it stalled out, and now it's come off that 18-day average on a closing basis by nearly 10 points. And that was just yesterday. The gold market testing support at the 1280 zone. Silver came back into support. You'll see that in a minute. Still basically there. Copper market giving up a little bit as the party conference, the 19th party conference in China, is underway. And each day that goes by, because of the time differences, we start hearing things, if you will, 12 hours later about what China is saying, what they're intending on doing. And it's going to impact the markets right through the 24th. The dollar down a little bit with a mixed currency market today. Look at how the yen came down. It actually got down to what we call that lower Bollinger Band area. In the different energy markets, notice I have moved to the Decembers, and I even moved in the grains to the January and the soybeans, but you'll see this market still looking pretty darn good. So as we come to the S&P, what can you say other than you're in an upthrust? On a weekly area chart, you've gone from 23,2750 to a new all-time high close, up a dramatic 230 points. I said that wrong. In no time at all, from basically before May, a dramatic, dramatic rally. Can the market hold on to these rallies into year end because they're so dramatic in scope? That's what we're all going to find out. I was on Fox Business today, and they asked, you know, what we were talking. I said, think of a vacuum cleaner. It's sucking up all the money. Everybody thinks they've been left behind. They're chasing into these markets. I may not be right on that statement, but here's what I am right on. Take a look at money market funds that are run on the exchanges and so on and that are tracked. You will see that the amount of money in them keeps crashing down, and we're watching monthly monies going into the stock market quite a bit. So that's where I'm making that statement from. If you take a look at the S&P, you've got 24.2475 is a low, and now on a closing basis, a new all-time high. When we come to the bar chart, you have this narrow volatility, and now the market's starting to break out again to the upside. The pattern has been one of higher lows. You can see them right there and higher highs. The pattern only gets broken now if you take out 2552, 35. So let's call it 2552, 30 will be that number. If it's taken out, the big question for everybody, does it get a bit of a correction in the market where you can get back to key moving averages? I wish I could tell you. I don't know. What I can tell you is there's room for this market to run to the upper Bollinger Band. It's still going to be 2577.50 tonight. I see nothing that is stopping that. You've got the embedded reading, and that's what I've said for you for days in and days out, with the exception of the Russell. That was the only one that lost, and it got down to its key moving average, and it's bouncing right away. The question was at one point, was the Russell break the prelude of something bigger in these indices? And the answer so far is no, it is not. In the Dow, right up to the upper Bollinger Band with the embedded reading. If you haven't seen the power of an embedded reading, you want to take my charting course. It's at www.irapstein.com. Go under the word education. You will see it there. Take a look at the short videos. You'll learn that I teach all this, and I teach you how to do it. I don't care if it's an ETF chart, a stock chart. A chart's a chart at the end of the day to me. in the slow stochastic, you still have the embedded reading. So yeah, we're getting a little bit of a pause in the NASDAQ here, but it's a pause at all-time highs, so let's not forget that. And the one market that broke, the Russell, went right down yesterday to its 18-day average and held it. Now, a problem for this market could develop if you were to come back down and take out yesterday's lows again. That would be an ugly signal for the small caps. Right now, what this market has to do is consolidate. All it did is move from a high back to support. Now the question is, what does it do from here? It is still in an overbought reading because I still have part of the stochastic at a 74 number. When I go into the VIX, and I'm looking at it hard, I'm going to say that I think that the other day I didn't have the arrows in the right spot. I don't trade the VIX. I look at it for momentum. And in looking, I had the higher high. Now I got higher lows with that. So I'm going to say you got higher highs, higher lows. You're getting stymied at the upper Bollinger Band. You keep pulling back to the 18-day average. Momentum is not overbought. It's flat. The trend is up. If you break down through this last low here of, let's call it 947, maybe you get to the lower band of 918. But I think at the moment, the bulls still have control of that. In TLT, the popular interest rate ETF, you've got a higher high, a lower low, which is no trend. Prices fell right back to the 18-day average today, and they held them. Momentum is overbought, market getting a bit of a correction. In the T-bond market, you fell from 154.5 down today to 152.25, went down, if you will, closing just slightly under that 18-day average of closes. But there's a loss here, for the moment at least, of the upside momentum, and you are in a correction against an overbought condition in the market. Remember, if the Fed is going to raise interest rates, typically futures go down unless you're playing different parts of the curve yield, and that's why the bonds have been so strong. It's further out, whereas the 10-year notes have been under a lot more weakness. They, too, though, aren't trending. They have a higher high now and a lower low. Today's low at 125.01.5 did take out this low. Momentum is rolling, but not yet pointing down. Market is void of a carry through one way or the other. In the dollar index is in an interesting time now. You have a period of a higher high and a lower low. If this market breaks down, until you take out this low really, which is against the lower Bollinger Band, it's hard to trade it one way or the other. I just think it's caught in this narrowing of these Bollinger Bands, and it's almost as though, as I said, the stock market is so strong it's pulling volatility out of everything. I can't answer why, but I can tell you that's what I'm seeing. Now, in the DEIS Euro, I'm suddenly seeing a pattern where you have an outside day up, you closed over the 18-day average, you have a pattern of higher highs. Now I'm going to declare it with higher lows, saying until today's low is taken out, very good chance this market has turned its trend, or is attempting to at least. And the question is, where's the Bollinger Band going to fall to? They are narrowing in. Do you see what they've done? How they've moved from way out here into there? Again, like the dollar index, a loss of volatility. You've turned the trend up in the Aussie dollar. Until you take out yesterday's lows, I have a pattern of higher lows, higher highs, with the market closing over the 18-day average. So the bias is up. The swing line is up, and momentum is still up, not yet in overbought territory, no readings over 70. In the Japanese yen, what you've done is you've narrowed in, just the way I'm showing you in the dollar index and the euro, how tight you are getting into these Bollinger Bands. Momentum has turned down, the bias is down, but you're not trending. And as I told you before, you're having trouble on each rally against Bollinger Band. Now you fell to the Bollinger Band bottom, basically. You missed it by four ticks, so I don't care if it hits it tonight or not. The question is there any follow-through one way or the other? And remember, if you're looking at safe haven currencies, this was one. I think this is just part of the market saying it's not worried about anything. In the Brent, look at the premium. You're still containing a big premium, $5.93 of the DEIS Brent over the WTI. Here's a Brent crude oil chart. You're against the upper Bollinger Band. You're overbought. Take the name off the chart. Would you be a buyer at an upper Bollinger Band in an overbought condition? That's how you ask yourself if you're going to do anything. My job here isn't to tell you to do it or not do it. Those are the questions that I teach you to ask yourself in my charting course. When I come to WTI crude, you're overbought, clearly in an uptrend. If the market can carry, maybe you can get up to a new high of 53.11. I don't know. We'll find out if these markets can continue on or if the $60 area is just too much at this point for the Brent. And if it doesn't go, does that mean that the WTI doesn't go? There's a lot of questions there we have to find out. Gasoline is still in an uptrend, but overbought. Higher lows, higher highs, bias up. I'd be looking for a lot of resistance in the 164.10 area, the first challenge of the Bollinger Band in a while. And heating oil's gone the other way. Suddenly, heating oil's let go to the downside. You have a higher high and a lower low, so it's no trend. But you stopped at the 100-day average for all purposes. And the question is, if you follow through to the downside, will the lower Bollinger Band support that market? So when I put it all together, there's questions, and one of the ways you can ask them is, do you understand not only what I'm teaching, but the other tools that I have? And I, believe me, in these videos, you're only learning part of them. How do you do that? Go to our website at www.irapstein.com. Take a look at the charting course we have up there. I think you'll find it very interesting. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I'll see you all tomorrow.